Good morning, dear children. Welcome to a new class of operations research. Today we are going to learn network analysis. This is very easy. Just you have to read the question, draw the network, that's all, and do the calculations. Okay, so let's learn. A project is composed of many jobs, activities which are related to each other, and they should be completed in a particular given time. So that's a project. And the activities of a project can only start at the completion of many other activities. A network is a combination of activities and events. Okay, network analysis provides techniques for planning. You have to plan it, you have to schedule it, and you have to control it. Later you have to monitor it. That is, if any changes, you have to make the modifications. So that is network analysis. You have to analyze. That is, you have to plan how this should be done. You have to schedule the project. You have to control and monitor the project. That is network analysis as a whole. Here's the objectives of network analysis. These are the objectives: minimization of total cost, minimization of total time, minimization of cost of a project, minimization of time of a project, minimization of idle resources. That is, all the resources, whatever you are using, it should have one or some other job. They should not sit idle. Minimization of production delays, interruptions. Interruptions or conflicts or delays should not come within the while we are working. Planning, scheduling, and controlling the projects. So these are the objectives of network analysis. Okay. Uses of network techniques for management. When it comes to the management, how you are using this network method. Helps the management in planning the complicated projects, controlling working plan, and also keeping the plan up to date. That is, you can control it. You can solve the complication in the projects using network techniques. Provide a number of checks, safeguards in developing the plan of the project. That is, in the meantime itself, we are checking whether we are in the correct path or not. Here comes the applications of network techniques: construction of building, bridges, factories, irrigation projects, administration, manufacturing, maintenance planning, research and development, inventory planning, and marketing. These are the applications of network techniques. Different phases in the application we have just discussed. That is, planning is there, scheduling is there, controlling is there. You have to make the proper plan. Without plan, you cannot do a project. It is not good to do a project without planning. So planning is the first step. You have to schedule how it is to be done. That is scheduling, which is a starting date, what is a completion date, and all. And what are the resources we have to use, that is scheduling. And then after making everything, you have to control it. You have to, this stage calls for updating of the network to monitor the progress of the project, whether it is in the correct way or not. So if any fault is there, make the modifications and then do the process. So that's it, planning, scheduling, and controlling. Okay, these are the phases of applications of network techniques. Now, some important terms are there. Activity, that's the first term. So this activity is a task associated with a project. It is a job associated with a project. Here, these are the nodes or the events. 2, 3 are the nodes or the events, and A is the activity. This is the activity which is being performed between the node 2 and the node 3, between the source and the destination. Okay, that is, activity is a work to be undertaken to materialize a specific event. Activity is denoted by a capital letter or any two numbers. Any two numbers means, you see, this activity can be represented by A, or it can be represented by 2 to 3. See this, 2 to 3. Okay, this way also you can represent an activity. That is what written here, two numbers. It is represented by an arrow. That is, arrow shows how the flow is going, which is a source and which is a destination. Okay. Here, 2 represents the initial node, that is the starting node, and 3 represents the terminal node or the finishing node. And A is the activity. 2 and 3 are the nodes or events. Just now we have seen start and terminal nodes. Start terminal is the node which is having no predecessors, and terminal node is a node which is having no followers or successors. Okay. Next is the term event or node. Events are represented by circles. In the previous example, we have seen 2 and 3 are the nodes. Okay. 2 is a tail node and 3 is the head node. Tail is the one which marks the beginning of an activity, and head is the one which marks ending of the activity. That is, it is moving forward. So head. Okay. So that is, but that is the end of the activity. That are the events and the nodes. Activities are represented by arrows and events are represented by circles. Here C is the predecessor of D. C is coming before D, right? So C is the predecessor of D and D is the successor of C. Okay, hope this much is okay for you. Next is a dummy activity. Dummy activity is a case where no time or resources are being used. So we know that to do a particular activity, the previous activity should be completed. Okay. So if it has not been completed, we have to complete it with dummy activity. See, D is the activity, and before starting D, B and C should be finished. Here, before starting D, B is not finished. B is kept like this. So it should be concluded. So that is why we are connecting the node 3 and 4 using this dummy line, and that is having no value, no cost, no time. Okay, so that is dummy activity. Today we have gone through the introduction of network analysis. We have gone through some terms. Hope everything was clear for you. Next class, we'll see how to draw a network if you are having a question with you. Okay, so see you in the next class. Thank you.